Hi, I'm Vinod from Dell Technologies Data Protection Technical Marketing Team. In this demonstration, we will walk through on the improved instant access and instant restore feature starting with DDOS 7.7 or later versions, and we will also see a live demo on how to perform instant access and instant restore of a Windows VM with PowerProtect Data Manager. Instant access is the ability to boot a VM directly from the PowerProtect DD series appliance and restore VM images or individual files in case of a disaster recovery in a virtualized environment. With instant access, the VM bootup is almost immediate when compared to traditional restore, where the VM bootup time is dependent on the speed of restore and size of the VM image. To perform a full restore of the VM, we can use the storage vMotion to move the VM image back to the production data store. When DD series appliances were introduced to market, we were able to claim up to 60K IOPS for the use case of instant restore. When running DDOS 7.7 or later, instant access and instant restore delivers high performance of virtual machines with up to 100K IOPS with the ability to instantly access up to 64 VMs simultaneously. DDOS 7.7 and later versions also offer improved performance on systems that are taking advantage of data address encryption. Please note that these values are based on Dell internal testing when using DDOS 7.7 and later on DD9900 appliance model. Actual results may vary. We will now perform an instant access and restore of a Windows VM which is previously backed up to DD series appliance using Data Manager. From the Data Manager UI, navigate to Restore, Assets. From the Virtual Machine tab, we can see all the virtual machine assets that has the backup copies available for restore. We will perform an instant access session for this Windows virtual machine. Before performing the instant access session, let's power off and delete the VM from the vCenter. This is the Windows VM that we need to power off and delete. We have now successfully powered off and deleted the Windows virtual machine. Let's navigate back to Data Manager UI. Select the Windows virtual machine, click on Restore, choose the respective backup copy. I'm choosing the latest backup copy available. Select Restore entire virtual machines. In the restore type, choose Instant Access VM. Select the vCenter and Data Center. In the restore location, select the host. In the network page, choose the respective network adapter and enable connected power on. Enter a name for the Instant Access VM. I'm unchecking power on the VM after restore completes. Review the summary and click on Restore. Let's monitor the Instant Access activity status from the Jobs page. We can also monitor the Instant Access operation status from the vCenter. From Recent Tasks. But let's monitor it from the Data Manager UI. Click on Running Sessions. Let's wait for the Instant Access session to get mounted. The mount is now complete. We have now exported an actual virtual machine data store with the backup image of that VM readily available to our production VM environment. We now see the instant access VM that is available on the vCenter. It is now actually living on the temporary data store called EMC vProxy. We have created this data store temporarily for usage by the VMware compute infrastructure. We can also view this NFS export session from the Data Domain System Manager. Navigate to Protocols, NFS. We can see the new export for a VM here, which means that the VM resides on DD series appliance for the time being. We can also see this under the active clients. Let's navigate back to vCenter and power on this VM. Launch Web Console. we can now instantly access and restore the files within this Windows virtual machine. We now see the virtual machine is up and running and can be instantly accessed. On confirmation of the VM that is required, we can now perform a live data store migration to the original data store. To perform migration from Data Manager UI, navigate to Restore, Running Sessions, click on the Instant Access session, click Migrate. Select the data store that is available, select Migrate to complete the operation. We can see the vMotion storage migration has started. We can monitor the progress from the Jobs page. We can also monitor the progress from the vCenter Recent Tasks section. We can see the relocate virtual machine in progress and migrating the virtual machine in the active state. Let's monitor it from the Data Manager UI. Step log. We can see the migrating copy step in progress. The job is now completed successfully. We can see the storage vMotion is complete and the temporary data store has been removed. Let's refresh the vCenter. We now see the virtual machine is available on the production data store. For more details on instant access and restore functionality, please visit Dell PowerProtect Appliance website and refer DDOS and Data Manager admin guides. Thanks for watching this demo.